Discuss today on bottom-up parsing techniques. Okay, so what happens in bottom-up parsing technique? A bottom-up parser creates the parse tree of the given input string, starting from the leaves towards the root, right? So if your tree is going to be look like this, there are the leaves, so it grows in this direction. It starts from the leaves and grows towards the root, right? So still now, previously what you have seen that we are generating derivation trees from root to leaves. That was a top-down approach. But now we will do in the reverse order. We'll follow a bottom-up approach, okay? And while you are doing this, there are many benefits. We will see slowly, okay? So bottom-up parser tries to find the rightmost derivation of the given input in the reverse order. So it does what? Rightmost derivation. So in top down, you can remember that we had only leftmost derivation, right? So now in case of bottom up, we are going to follow rightmost derivation in reverse order, okay? So if we have something like, S at the root and at the leaf, you have a string given by this omega, then the rightmost derivation of W will start. That means, even on the derivation notation, we are writing like this, but it happens actually bottom up parser find the rightmost derivation in the reverse order. That means the thing will happen in this direction. Okay, so example of bottom up parsing for given string here, that is ID multiplication ID. Okay, so how we can parse it in bottom-up manner? So we can do one thing, and we can just note what we have given, that is ID multiplication ID. This is our given string. We need to generate parse tree for this, right? A derivation tree for this using bottom-up parse. Okay, that means we have to start from the leaf and we have to go towards the top, right, toward the root. Okay, so what is there in bottom-up parsing? We do one thing, we read this input from left to right. Okay, we read this input from left to right and we do the derivation using rightmost derivation. Okay, and while we are moving from leaves to root. So what will be there at the root? Definitely the start symbol of the grammar, that is the E here in this case. So root is always the start symbol of the grammar. Okay. So just a minute. So we are reading left to right, and based on what we are reading, based on that, we will take the decision, right? So if we read this input from left to right, we are going to read this ID first, okay? So on this ID, we will do a rightmost derivation, okay? So we can say this ID is derived from F using the rule F to ID, it is here, you can see F2, ID is here. So using this rule, you can say we reduce it like this. Now, We are doing rightmost derivation, right? So right now we have this f. No, so you know, at this point we can't choose, you know, left or right, because at this level we have only one symbol to reduce. Okay, so this f can be derived from what? We have t to f, right? So we get it like this. Okay. So I, how much will do keep doing this until we are getting failure to get a handle or to get something, you know, some grammar rule which can reduce further. So we have t. If you see again, if we try to do a rightmost derivation on t, what will happen? You know, t, there is nothing which is okay. There is a, there is e to t even, but if we just do e to t, what will happen? Our derivation ends there because we reached to the, you know, starting symbol of the grammar. As I have told you, the start symbol of the grammar is the root, right? So we say this is the root, so our parsing will get failure. So in this case, what we will do, we will not go with this rule. Okay, instead we will read the next input symbol. So next input symbol we are getting is star. Now, so what we have in our hand, we have t and star. So t and star together, using this, we can't choose a rule from here, right? Because there is no rule whose body is t only t star. So that is not there, right? So again, we will go for reading the next input symbol, that is id. Okay, so we'll reduce this id by f. Now after doing this, what is there in our hand? T multiplication sign and asterisk and this f. So if you see here, we have a rule that t asterisk f, and which is reducible from reducible to t. Now still we have not reached to the start symbol of the grammar, so we have to find out that how we can reduce this t to the start symbol. So we have a e to t rule right here, e to t. So we can do this, yeah, right? So you can see here, we had started from the leaves and we have grown in this direction using left to right reading of the input symbols and rightmost derivation, and finally we reached to the root, and which is also the start symbol of the grammar. So we can say at this point, at this situation, that our parsing was a successful, or this string is accepted by this grammar, right? So this is what the basic concept of bottom-up parsing. Okay, so here you can see the step-by-step process of the bottom-up parsing, what I have shown you. Now reduction. So many times I was telling you this word, that reduction. So what happens in reduction? Reduction is just a reverse step in a derivation. So previously we was using this word derivation. So what was happening in derivation? We was derive something from a symbol. Like, you know, if we do e to e plus t. So this has happened in this direction, and this is called derivation. But if you have e plus t in your hand and you are just going to the reverse of the derivation, so in this direction, and you are choosing to reduce this thing to e, then we will call this on a reduction. Okay, so this is reduction and this is called derivation. Okay. Now process of reducing a string W to start symbol of the grammar, right? So that is what we have done in the previous example. And each reduction step, a specific substring matching the body of a production is replaced by non-terminal at the head of the production, right? So what is the head of a production? Production means a production rule. So if you have this production rule, A to E plus T, we call this one a head, and this is body, okay? Now, we have already seen for this given string how this will be created, the revision tree, okay? Now, handle. Informally, a handle is a string. A handle of a string is a substring that matches the right side of a production rule. So, right, if you have something like this, you know, ID plus ID, okay? Then this ID can be treated as a handle if we have a production rule F to ID. What we had, right, previously, you know, F to ID is a production rule we had in the given grammar, right? So if this production rule is there, then the body of the rule and the substring available in a given string, if these two things are same, then we can call this substring is a handle, okay? So, but not every substring matches the right side of a production rule is handle. So, and not all the time we will call them handle, because there is a reason that only matching is not everything, right? Like, you know, here we have seen, you know, this T was, you know, possible to reduce to E. So will we call this T handle at that situation? We will not call it a handle, because if we pick this T as a handle, then, you know, it is not going to give us success in this parsing technique, right? So every substring will not be called as a handle, okay? Now, a handle of a right sentinel form is given like, you know, given by this, what is it called? Gamma, right? Given by gamma, and say it is equivalent to alpha, beta, and omega. Then a production rule, A to beta and a position of gamma where the string beta may be found and replaced by A to produce the previous right sentinel form in a rightmost derivation of gamma. If it happens, then we will say that this beta is a handle. Okay, like you can see here, we had alpha, beta, and omega. We done a rightmost derivation, and we reduce this beta to A. Right. So we do this. So this is going to be called, this beta is going to be called a handle. Okay. Now, if grammar is unambiguous, then every right sentinel form of the grammar has exactly one handle. So this is another condition here, that if the grammar is unambiguous, it is not a ambiguous grammar, right? Then in that case, the grammar will have exactly one handle, okay? We will see that omega is a string of terminal, right? So we know that we use omega to represent a string of terminals, right? So right sentinel form, if you see here in this, mm-hmm. we have given a string that is id 1 into id 2. So this 1 and 2 are given only to distinguish between appearance of id in two places, two different places, right? So there is no other significance of id 1 and id 2. This is only the place of an occurrence of this id, okay? So first, what handle we will get here for this derivation? We will get, we're doing left to right read, right? So we're reading the string from left to right. So id 1 becomes our first handle. And why it is becoming our handle? Because we have production rule, what we can treat as reducing production, which is f to id, right? Then we can write that it became a multiplication id 2, right? So what handle we get here? Say f, okay? Now we can do what? T to f, we have this production rule which can be, due to which we are treating this f as handle, right? Then star is a, for star we can't treat this star or f star together as a handle, so we are ignoring them and skipping, and we are taking this id 2. Okay, so what we have here, and after this reduction, t multiplication id 2, so neither t or t star becomes a handle, so we just take id 2 here as a handle. Okay, so id 2 can be again reduced by f to id, and if we do this, then our reduction here in this side becomes t multiplication f. Okay, now t multiplication f can be treated as a handle because there is a production rule which is t to t multiplication f, right? So we can use this as a handle, this whole thing as a handle, and we replace it by t. Okay, so next we can treat this t also as a handle because we have production rule e to t. So this t will become e, and e will not be treated as a handle anymore because there is no production rule which is producing this e, or which have e on the right side. So it is not possible to reduce anymore. Okay, so this is what are the things and terminologies to understand is right sentinel form. These are the things called right sentinel form. Handle, these are the things called handle, and the reducing productions used to replace the handle or reduce the handle by the head of the production rule. Now, handle pruning. A rightmost derivation is in reverse can be obtained by handle pruning. So, again, the same way, S is the starting symbol of the grammar and omega is the input string, consist of only terminals. Okay, so you can see that which is equivalent to gamma n here, right? So gamma n is if you do the rightmost derivation, it gives you this gamma n minus one and so on, like this. You come to gamma two, then after some reduction from gamma two, you reach to gamma one and so on. You do in this direction, right? So starting from gamma n, find a handle an to bn in gamma n and replace beta n by an to get gamma n minus 1. So when we are doing, coming from this gamma n to gamma n minus 1 state, when we are getting in this gamma n, you have some beta n, you find it. And this beta n is replaced by some production rule head an as as if you have a production rule that is an to beta n. Okay, and this thing is continuing for every step, for one reduction like this, and this things is known as Handel pruning. Then find the Handel beta n minus one in gamma n minus one. So after doing this thing, you just reach to gamma n minus one. Again in gamma n minus one, what you have to find some beta n minus one, which can be replaced by some grammar symbol a n minus one. Okay, and replace beta n minus one by a minus one to get gamma n minus two. And so on, it will keep reducing. Okay, repeat this two until you find S. S is the starting symbol of the grammar. Understand? Now, bottom-up parsing. Bottom-up parsing is also known as shift-reduce parsing because its two main actions are shift and reduce. So in bottom-up parsing, you will find that two things are happening. One is called shift and another is called reduce, right? So already you have seen the reduce things. I think quite clear what is reduce and how it happens. Now at each shift action, the current symbol in the input string is pushed onto a stack. So we will have a stack. Okay, and whenever we'll have some shift operation, we will push the current symbol onto the stack. Now, at each reduction step, basically this shift, this content of the stack will help us to do the reduction. Okay, so the reduction step, At each reduction step, the symbols at the top of the stack, top of the stack will be replaced by the non-terminal at the left side of that production. Understand? So what we will get in the stack, we will get a handle, sometimes, and these handles will be replaced by the left side of the production rule, which is nothing but the head of the production rule. So there are also two more actions called accept and error. So you can understand or guess when this accept action will happen, when we will do the final reduction and we will only have and we will reach to the start symbol S. Say S is the start symbol for a grammar. Then we will say that this final action is going to be accept. Okay. And if it is not possible to do any decision, then it is going to be called as error. So all these two things.